1.
Okay, so in the previous section, we have seen how to calculate the FI filter coefficient using the window method and specifically using the Hamming window. Now in this case, we are going to see specifically how using the Kaiser window, we are going to calculate the FI filter coefficients. Okay, so most of the formulas which are required for solving this problem I have written on the board. Even I have given the specifications, but still I have read out the problem for you all. That is, obtain the coefficients of a linear phase FI filter using the Kaiser window to satisfy the following amplitude response specification. And specifications given are pass band ripple is 0.01 dB, stop band attenuation is 40 dB, transition width is 500 Hz, sampling frequency is 10 kHz, ideal cutoff frequency is 1200 Hz. So this is the thing what they have given. We need to find out the filter coefficients, and as in the case of previous case, we are going to use the same formula, that is h of n equal to hd of n into omega of n. Now hd of n is the ideal impulse response, so it depends upon whether we are using low pass, whether we are designing a filter using low pass, high pass, band pass or band stop filter. So we will assume that we are making use of, we are trying to design a filter, FI filter using low pass. So the formula remains same, hd of n equal to 2 times fc sine and omega c upon n omega c, for n not equal to 0, and for n equal to 0 it becomes 2 times fc. Now, window function in the case of Hamming window was different. In this case, in the case of Kaiser window, the formula becomes W of n, and I have already written whatever the formula for the window function that we require. And again, n is going to be less than or equal to plus or minus n minus 1 divided by 2. So, this means that we need to first of all find out the filter length n. But to find out the filter length n, capital N, the formula is n is greater than or equal to a minus 7.25 upon delta f into 14.36. So you can see there are so many terms, and we don't know most of those terms. A is given minimum of delta p over delta s. Delta p is the pass band elevation, this is the stop band ripple. A, there is minimum of this, is we are going to substitute over here, and then we are going to calculate the value of a. We require to find out even delta f. Let us start with a very small term, that is delta f, which is given by nothing but transition width. It's a normalized transition width. So delta f is transition width divided by the sampling frequency. Transition width has been given as 500 Hz and sampling frequency has been given as 10 kHz. So that gives us the value of delta f to us as 0.05. So using this value, we are going to put it over here, but before that we need to find out this value of A. Now A is equal to minimum of delta P comma delta S. So we need to find out what is this delta P and what is this delta S. Those formula which are required are written on the board towards the downside. You can see equals the left, delta P is equal to 10 raised to. So I'll already substitute over here. Delta P is equal to 10 raised to 0.05 AP. AP is the pass band ripple that they have given. And this AS is the stop band attenuation which is required in the case of delta S, that is the stop band attenuation 40 dB. So this is 0.05 into 0.01 minus 1 divided by 0.05 into 0.01 plus 1. That uses the value of delta P as 0.00057. Similarly, calculating the value of delta S using the formula, the other one is 10 raised to power of minus 0.05 AS is the stop band attenuation given as 40 dB, gives us the answer after calculating those values. We get it at 0.01. So we have calculated delta P, we have calculated delta S. So let us use the next formula, that is A is minimum of delta P, that is 0.00057 comma 0.01, and we can see that the minimum of this is 0.00057. Now this is nothing but a value of delta, so we are going to put this value in the actual formula of A, and the actual formula of A has been given as minus 20 log to the base 10 of delta, and this delta is nothing but 0.00057. So I'll do the calculation over here. A, we get it as minus 20 log to the base 10 0.00057. That gives us the value of A as 64.8 dB. I'll write down this value over here. A as 64.8 dB. So have this part and I can do the further calculation. Once we have calculated A and delta F, later on we can directly start with how to find out this N, that is the filter length N. We have already calculated the value of A at 64.8 minus 7.95 divided by delta F has been calculated as 0.05 into 14.36, which gives us the answer for N as, that is the filter length as, 33.03, and you can see that it is equivalent to 33. So this n, which is less than or equal to plus or minus n minus 1 by 2, so n we can get it as 16. That means that we need to find out the values of n going from minus 16 to plus 16. But again, in the question they have specified as calculate the first three coefficients of FIR filter. That is, we need to find out for n equal to 0, n equal to 1, and n equal to 2. For n equal to 0, the formula becomes h of 0 equal to hd of 0 into w of 0. Let us start with hd of 0, which is nothing but 2 times fc dash. This is a new fc dash. Again, we need to calculate this new fc dash, which is given by fc plus transition width divided by 2. Fc is the ideal cutoff frequency, that is 1200, plus transition width is given as 500. Divided by 2 gives us the answer as 1450 Hz, and it is 1450 Hz, but it is not in a normalized frequency format, so we have to again divide it by a sampling frequency. So this is 2 times fc dash divided by fs. Why fs? Because we need to normalize it. So 2 times fc we have already calculated as 1450, and sampling frequency is 10 kHz, which gives us the answer of hd of 0 as 0.290. The next step is to calculate omega of 1, and omega of 1 we are going to make use of the formula of Kaiser window, which is given as omega of n equal to I naught of beta 1 minus 2n upon n square whole raised to n square root divided by again I naught of beta. Now we can see that in this case, in this formula, there are a number of terms which are not being calculated. Some of them we know already. This n is going to be, whether it is 0, 1 or 2. This capital N is a filter length that we have calculated as 33. And this beta is a value that we have not calculated, which is called as a ripple parameter. And this beta value depends upon what is the value of A that we have calculated. We have got a value of A 64.8. And you can see over here, I have written beta is equal to 0 for A less than or equal to 21 dB. It is this for A going from 21 to 50, A line between 21 to 50, and for A greater than 50, this is the formula. Now since A is 64.8, we are going to make use of formula 0.110, that is the third one, because A is greater than 50 dB. A we have already calculated at 64.8 minus 8.7. which gives us the value of, this is the value of beta. So we get the value of beta as 6.19. Okay, let us now substitute in case of window function, that is I naught of beta at 6.19, then it is 1 minus 2n. So since n is 0, this is obviously going to become 0 whole divided by I naught of again 6.19. And we can see that since this term becomes 0, the numerator and denominator terms are the same. That is I naught of 6.19 and I naught of 6.19. So both are going to get cancelled out, and I am going to get a value of w of 1 as, that is omega of 1 as 1. So now next step is to calculate h of 1, which is nothing but hd of 1 into w of 1. We have already calculated hd of 1 at 0.290, and we know that w of 1 is 1, so we are going to left with the answer of 0.290. So this is the value of n, this is the value of first value of filter coefficient, that is for n equal to 0, h of 0 we have Let us start with n equal to 1 and the rest of the part again like a previous section you can continue at home. Let us start with n equal to 1. So for n equal to 1, the formula becomes h of 1 equal to hd of 1 into omega 1. Hd of 1 is given by 2 times fc dash sine of n omega c, there is nothing but 2 pi fc dash whole divided by n into 2 pi fc dash. You can see that omega c, this omega c is given by formula called as 2 pi fc dash. We have already calculated fc dash, so let us now directly substitute the values. Fc dash is nothing but 0.145. This fc dash is the 145, so that is where calculated fc dash divided by the normalized divided by the sampling frequency. So after dividing 1450 divided by the 10 kilohertz, we get it at 0.145 into sine of n is 1, so 2 pi fc again it is 0.145 divided by 2 pi into 0.145, which gives us the answer of hd of 1 as 0.015. Next step is to calculate the value of this window function at 1. So it is I naught of beta, we already know beta 06.19, 1 minus 2, this time n is 1. So 2 upon n is 33 square raised to half and divided by I naught of beta is 6.19. So I am going to left with the answer of I naught of. So after simplification of this, there is 6.19 into this bracket 1 minus 2 by 33 square and then the root. We get the answer as again this, it comes to around 6.19 itself because this term almost becomes 1. So it comes close to 1, but let us assume that it is very very close to 1. So we have assumed that it is 1. So it comes to I naught of 6.19 divided by I naught of 6.19. So again we can see that both the terms are the same, I naught of 6.19, I naught of 6.19. They are going to get cancelled out and they are going to be left with the answer of 1. But for an example, for example purpose, how to calculate this I naught of whatever the value that we are left with. For that we are going to make use of this formula, that is I naught of x equal to 1 plus 0.25 x square upon 1 factorial plus 0.25 x square the whole square upon 2 factorial the square, and it goes on till the power of 6. That means that we are going to make use of this formula, that is I naught of 6.19 will be wherever the values of x are, we are going to replace it by 6.19. So just for illustration purpose, I naught of this 6.19 is calculated as follows: 1 plus 0.25 6.19 square upon 1 factorial, so it will be 1.25 into 6.19 the square whole square divided by 2 factorial square, and it goes on till 0.25 into 6.19 square raised to the power 6 upon 6 factorial square. So after simplifying this, we are going to left with the answer of I naught of x as 79.619. So again in this case, since I naught of 6.19, we are left with the value of W of 1 x, sorry, omega of 1 x, I naught of 6.19 divided by I naught of 6.19. Both are going to get cancelled and we are going to get the answer as 1. So next step is to calculate h of 1, which is nothing but hd of 1 into omega of 1. We have calculated hd of 1 as 0.015 and omega of 1 is 1. So we are going to be left with the answer of 0.015. This is the value for h of for n equal to 1. In similar case, in similar way we can calculate the values of n equal to 2, 3, 4 till 16.
Okay.